A very good afternoon. You're watching the Midday News on Rajya Sabha Television, where we get you the biggest developing news stories at the top of one. I'm Ashwarya, and these are the headlines. Supreme Court directs the water levels at Mulaperia Reservoir to be maintained at 139 feet till 31st of August in view of Kerala floods. Directs Tamil Nadu and Kerala governments to cooperate and follow the directions of the panel on Mulaperia Dam. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman visits flood-affected areas in Kodagu in Karnataka. 17 people have died since last week following torrential rains. Schools in Kangra and Mandi in Himachal Pradesh closed following forecast of very heavy rains. Supreme Court turns down the pleas seeking cancellation of elections in over 20,000 uncontested local body seats in West Bengal. Asks aggrieved candidates to file election petitions to challenge panchayat polls in court's concern. Scott Morrison set to become Australia's sixth Prime Minister in just over 10 years. Malcolm Turnbull forced out by rivals in leadership contest for Liberal Party. Morrison wins internal ballot 45-40, ending days of political chaos. And India's medal tally swells to 23 at the Asian Games. Rohan Bopanna and Divij Sharan back gold in men's doubles tennis. Second goal in men's quadruple sculls. India also bags the 3 bronze medals today. First up, all the updates from flood-ravaged Kerala. The Supreme Court has directed that water levels at the Mulaperia Reservoir be maintained at 139 feet till 31st of August in view of Kerala floods. The apex court also directed the governments of Tamil Nadu and Kerala to cooperate and follow the directions of the panel on Mulaperia Dam. A disaster management subcommittee to monitor the water levels of the dam on Thursday had asked Tamil Nadu to keep the water limit of the reservoir 2 to 3 feet below the 142 feet FRL mark till 31st of August. The committee comprising officials from the centre, including the Water Resources Ministry, as well as Kerala and Tamil Nadu, reviewed the water level of the reservoir, and Kerala had on a Thursday told this apex court that the sudden release of water from the Mulaperia Dam by the Tamil Nadu government was one of the reasons for the devastating deluge in the state. Meanwhile, the centre has said that the 600 crore rupees released for the Kerala floods was only advance assistance, and additional funds would be released when an interministerial team will visit the state again and assess the damage. The Home Ministry said this in a statement as there were differences really emerging on accepting funds from foreign governments, with the UAE offering support of 700 crore rupees. The centre has said that the decision to not accept that help is in sync with the existing policy. Earlier on Tuesday, the central government had released 600 crore rupees as promised by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Home Minister Rajnath Singh during their visit to the state. And Union Minister K.J. Alphonse has requested the centre to make a one-time exception for Kerala on the issue of accepting foreign funds. Alphonse was reacting to the centre's decision to not accept foreign funds in line with the 14-year-old policy that has been followed so far. Alphonse said that the NDA has inherited the policy from the previous UPA government. And speaking to PTI, Alphonse said that Kerala has contributed huge amounts of foreign exchange through remittance in the last 50 years. He said that the state is also the biggest tourist destination in the country, and for this reason, a one-time exception policy needs to be made for the state.
Lot of homes have collapsed. The homes, houses don't exist. Even the rest of the houses which are there, 2 lakh houses, you can't go back to them because you have at least 3 feet of silt in every room in the house. Most of the houses, are in absolutely bad shape. There is no electricity, there are no utensils, there is of course no food. Everybody is looked after very well in the relief camps, but then when they go back home, how do they put their lives together? Now, this is where the nation needs to come together, and all Indians must come together. Kerala needs big money. Very, very big money for reconstruction. Of the Honorable Prime Minister has directed the National Highway Authority of India to restore the roads. Whole lot of assistance is being provided by the various agencies of the ministry, but we need huge amount of money, billions and billions of dollars, to rebuild Kerala. Now we need that big money. Please send big assistance to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund or to NGOs. The best is to send it to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund or to NGOs which have credentials.
And our correspondent Akhilesh Sumana spoke with the volunteers of a Seva Bharati organization who are assisting the families in cleaning the flood-ravaged houses ahead of the biggest festival of the state, Onam. And the volunteers said that they will try to ensure that sufficient food supply is provided to the families ahead of the festival.
Seva Bharati ke logon ne pahle bhi बाढ़ पीड़ित इलाकों में काफ़ी काम किया है और कहा जाता है कि सेवा भारती इस मामले में काफ़ी दक्ष हो गई है। केरल में आई बाढ़ के बाद कई जगहों पे लोग ने राहत में काम किया, बचाव में काम किया।
कम से कम 30 का ऊपर काम क्या चल रहा है इधर। हम लोग कोने कोने में, इधर का जो फ्लड होता है ना, इधर का कोने कोने घर में जाके 4-5 आदमी एक घर में जाके पूरा साफ करके उस लोगों का मदद करता है। इधर चंगनूर और पतनदा सब जगह में ये सारा काम चल रहा है इधर।
तो ये कैसे आप लोग इन लोगों को इकट्ठा करते हैं?
जो किधर भी फ्लड ऐसा एक दुर्घटना होता है तो स्वयं से लोग उसी टाइम उधर आके काम कर सकते हैं, आपने लोगों को मदद कर सकता है।
चिंगनूर के वंडीमला टेम्पल का ऑडिटोरियम है, आप देख रहे हैं ये ऑडिटोरियम अभी सामान से भर गया है, एक तरीके के गोदाम बन गया है। ये जो सामान है ये सब कहाँ से आया?
ये सामान पूरा केरल से विविध कोने कोने से आ रहा हो, हमारे शाखा से और से, और हमारा स्वयं सेवक ने स्वयं कलेक्ट किया है। कल तमिलनाडु से 2-3-4 ट्रक आया था, अभी हमारा नॉर्थ इंडिया से भी ट्रक आ रहा है।
कितने दिनों से चला रहे हैं आप ये राहत सामग्री वितरित करने का काम?
15 अगस्त की रात पूरा हमारा इधर घर में फ्लड आ गया। उसके तुरंत हमारा स्वयं सेवक ने और रक्षा प्रवर्तन के लिए आ गया। हमारे लगभग हमने 30,000 लोगों को रक्षक किया। 18 तारीख से ये चल रहा है, अभी 4 दिन हो गया और लगभग और 2-3 हफ्ते ये रहेगा। परसों हमारा ओणम है, हमारा देश त्यौहार है, लेकिन इतना दुर्भाग्य घटना के वजह से हमने ओणम सेलिब्रेट नहीं कर रहे, लेकिन हमारा घर के लिए ये सब सामान हम डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं। लेकिन ये सिर्फ हमारा कैंप के लिए नहीं है, हम एक एक घर में ये पहुंचता है।
And as the water continues to recede from most of the areas in the state, medical help is becoming one of the major requirements for the flood-ravaged people. Now, many volunteers are moving from one settlement to the other to extend medical facilities to the ailing people. Our correspondent Akhilesh Suman also visited one such medical camp in Chengannur and he interacted with the volunteers there. Let's take a listen.
मेडिकल की सर्विसेज नहीं मिल रही, वहाँ एम्बुलेंस लेके खड़े होते हैं, लोगों को जानकारी देते हैं, वो वहाँ आते हैं, उनको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा स्किन की बीमारी है या निमोनिया है किसी को, तो हम उनको दवा दे रहे हैं और उनको वो कुछ बीमारी न होने के लिए क्या करना है, यानी साफ़ सुथरा पानी पीना है, खाना साफ़ सुथरा खाना है, ये सब हम उनको बताते हैं। अभी प्रिवेंशन भी उनको सिखा रहे हैं।
वी आर सेग्रीगेटिंग द मेडिसिन हियर एंड वी गॉट इट फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर इंडिया, एस्पेशली फ्रॉम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैंप्स एंड अदर सेवा संघ एंड इंडिविजुअल्स एंड सम डॉक्टरेट्स। आफ्टर गेटिंग द डॉक्टर कंसल्टेशन वी आर सेग्रीगेटिंग दिस मेडिसिन टू ईच कैंप्स।
And in fact, after going from Chengannur, Akhilesh Suman is right now with us. He is in Thiruvananthapuram. A very good afternoon, Akhilesh. We are seeing, you know, this blame game over the devastating floods in Kerala really escalating. Tamil Nadu objecting to Kerala's claim that the deluge was triggered by release of water from the reservoir. And now the Supreme Court is directing that the water level of the Mulla Periyar Dam be maintained at 139 feet. So how are the people of Kerala, you know, reacting to all this? Because, you know, they are basically obviously looking to bring their lives back on track. And amid all this, this entire politics is happening over this issue.
From here, that Kerala people are getting involved in this point of time, and volunteers from various groups have gathered in this area. In Chengaluru is the worst affected area, and you can see behind me also young people who are associated with SFI, you know, that organization related to CPIM, and they have also been involved in the cleaning process. So basically, a positive competition is going on among various political groups.
And their affiliated groups about how to take the state out of this whole dirt and out of the ravage of the floods. So whenever you talk to people, they are telling that it is a broader issue that will be decided on the basis of government, and governments of the two states will decide in contact with the center. But the major issue in Kerala, youth of the state are really motivated to keep the state on the normal and to take the state in a normal situation so that they can forget. And people are also mentioning, these volunteers are also mentioning that there has been emotional crisis also in some of the families, because either they have lost someone, or they had been in bad situation for a long time, or they lost the cattle, or even dogs have been in bad shape. So they are all feeling many types of situations, and that is why they need volunteers. Volunteers, when they are going to some houses, they are feeling that yes, it is a help in addition to the government. And basically, this type of micro work cannot be fulfilled by the government, you know, Aishwarya, because government works on a different plane, and government is basically in the relief operation after the rescue operation, and they are conducting the relief camps, basically coordinating various issues and various things. But at the micro level, you will find that Kerala people have grown, and they are going from house to house on the basis of fraternity, on the basis of family, and also on the basis of area to area they are moving, and they have come from different areas, from Thiruvananthapuram, from Mallapuram, from Ernakulam, from various parts of the state where they have not been affected. They have come here and they are helping the local people. So Malla Periyar and Kerala issue is not making a big noise as far as people of Kerala is concerned. It will be decided by the court or by the respective governments and the center, Aishwarya.
Right, indeed. Even as politics continue on what caused the floods and who is responsible, it is really the people of Kerala who are, you know, helping each other and ensuring that they get their lives back on track. Thank you so much, Akhilesh, for all those ground updates from Kerala. All right, let's get you some other news now. Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman also has visited a flood and a landslide hit Kodagu district in Karnataka today. Rescue and relief operations are on in full swing in the state since torrential rains lashed the district last week, leaving a huge trail of destruction and claiming at least 17 lives. More than 5,000 people have been rendered homeless. The defense minister visited landslide hit areas of Madhapur, and she took stock of the situation there. She also visited a relief camp there and interacted with the families there. The defense minister will also hold meetings with the district administration and other officials at the deputy commissioner's office on the relief and rehabilitation work that is being carried out. And during her visit, she said that some of the roads, houses, buildings, water and electricity connection in Kodagu will be done by the army, and the air force is also trying to help. And 51 relief camps have been set up in Kodagu that are currently housing 5,041 people, including 4,450 who were rescued and brought to safety. According to preliminary estimates, around 2,200 houses have also been damaged. Meanwhile, in the state of Madhya Pradesh, due to heavy rainfall, gates of several dams of the states have been opened, and many villages in the state have lost road connectivity as the rivers are flowing above the danger mark. The IMD has issued warnings of heavy rains in 14 districts of the state in the next 24 hours. The maximum amount of rainfall has been recorded in Bhopal in the western parts of Madhya Pradesh, where Over 7 inches of rainfall was recorded, and due to non-stop rainfall, the gates of the Gagdil Sagar Dam were opened, while 14 gates of the dam in Retam, 15 gates of Rajkar Dam in Chanderi, and 2 gates of Mohanpura Dam were also opened. Road connectivity between Madhya Pradesh and UP near Chanderi has also been disturbed. Water level in the upper lake of Bhopal has increased up to 1,660 feet. An update from Himachal, where educational institutions in Kangra and Mandi districts are closed today due to the forecast of heavy rains. Announcing the decision for Kangra, the deputy commissioner, however, said that all medical institutions would remain open. Now, people have been urged to stay away from rivers and earlier at least 19 people were killed in the state in flash floods and landslides triggered by heavy rains on 13th of August. In Midday News, time for a very short break. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back after the break. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has said that hospitals and doctors must interact with the patients and their families with empathy and compassion. He said that such an approach will give the patient a healing touch and help them feel better during their treatment. Inaugurating the KIMS hospital in Visakhapatnam, Vice President stressed on the need to take measures to bring down the expenditure on health. He also stressed on the need to make affordable healthcare available to masses. He also asked the doctors to adopt a service-oriented approach while discharging their duties as medical practitioners. He has also asked the doctors to encourage people to take active participation in physical activities. And the Supreme Court has turned down the pleas seeking cancellation of the elections on over 20,000 uncontested local body seats in West Bengal. All these uncontested seats were won unopposed by the candidates of the ruling Trinamool Congress, and the opposition parties had alleged that their candidates were obstructed from filing their nomination papers. The Apex Court, however, took a note of the allegations and said that the aggrieved candidates may file the election petitions to challenge panchayat polls in the courts concerned. The court also held that the limitation period of 30 days for filing the election petitions, which has expired, would now commence from the date of notification of panchayat poll results. It also set aside the Calcutta High Court decision directing the state poll panel to allow the filing of nomination papers in panchayat elections through electronic forms such as emails and WhatsApp. Out of a total 58,692 posts for a Gram Panchayat village, Zila Parishad and Panchayat Samiti, 20,159 had remained uncontested in the violence-marred local body polls in the state that were held in May this year. And for the first time, the militaries of India and Pakistan are taking part in a mega anti-terror drill of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, or the SCO, in Russia. Now, this drill is aimed at expanding cooperation among the member states to deal with the growing menace of terrorism and extremism. And India is participating in the drill for the first time since becoming a full member of the SCO in June 2017. An Indian contingent of 200 personnel is primarily composed of troops from the infantry and the affiliated arms and services along with the Indian Air Force. The joint exercise is being conducted by the Central Military Commission of Russia from 22nd of August to 29th of August in Russia. The SCO, remember, was established in Shanghai in 2001, with China, Russia, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan and Uzbekistan as its founding members. And it expanded to include India and Pakistan in 2017. A big international focus, Scott Morrison is set to become Australia's next Prime Minister after he replaced Malcolm Turnbull as the leader of the Liberal Party. Morrison will now lead the Conservative Party, which is known as the Liberal Party, in a general election expected in the coming months. Morrison won a three-way battle for the leadership of the Liberal Party, with the incumbent Malcolm Turnbull not contesting the party ballot. Morrison, who has been serving as the country's treasurer, defeated former Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton by 45 votes to 40 at the closed-door leadership vote. And US President Donald Trump has also said that the stock market would plummet if he were to be removed from office. Speaking to Fox News in an interview, Donald Trump said that the markets would crash if he were to be impeached. "I think everybody would be very poor," he said. Donald Trump's comments came after his two former advisors were found guilty of criminal acts and one implicating him directly. Donald Trump's personal lawyer, Michael Cohen, pleaded guilty to 8 felony counts, and his former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, was convicted of 8 counts of tax and bank fraud. Now, these events have boosted the speculation that Donald Trump could be impeached. All the action now from the Asian Games. Got its sixth gold medal at the 18th Asian Games in Indonesia today. Indian duo of Rohan Bopanna and Divij Sharan won the gold medal in the men's doubles tennis. Swaran Singh, Dattu Babban and Om Prakash and Sukhmeet Singh bagged gold in the men's quadruple sculls. And in the men's lightweight double sculls, Rohit Kumar and Bhagwan Singh won bronze medal. Also, Dushyant bagged a bronze medal in the men's lightweight single sculls category. And in women's 10 meters air pistol, Hina Sindhu bagged a bronze medal. Looking at the medals tally now, India is placed 7th in the medals tally with the 23 medals that include 6 gold, 4 silver and 13 bronze medal. While China with 122 medals including 59 gold tops the medals tally, followed by Japan with 89 medals including 26 golds. And South Korea is placed at the 3rd position with 68 medals including 19 gold medals. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Midday News. Thanks for watching.